Hello, third grade, and welcome to lesson four. What can comparing different communities tell us about global cultures? In this lesson, you'll use your investigative skills to compare and contrast cultures in two different countries. Reading and talking about different cultures helps you understand people's lifestyle, traditions, holidays, and other aspects of their cultures. In the picture we have on this page, it says Mapungubwe cultural landscape in South Africa, and you can see the photo with the elephant in it and the nature backdrop. And then on the right side of the page, it says Machu Picchu in Peru. Let's go ahead and get into our reading. Now remember to check the blue bars on the side so you know what information you're looking for. Read the title. What do you think the text will be about? Underline words or phrases that tell about the Inca civilization. Circle the phrases that tell about the Mapungubwe cultural landscape. Discuss with a partner what you notice about the different artifacts. Then for number two, reread. What was unique about the Inca and Mapungubwe cultural landscapes? What was the same about their cultures? Look for details that show these differences and similarities. Look at the captions. What conclusion can you draw about each artifact? So what do you notice or what do you think based on what they're telling you about each one of these artifacts? How was each artifact used? Was the purpose similar or different and why? And for number three, what comparisons can you make between these cultures based on their artifacts? And how do these artifacts compare to objects that are important to you? Cultural artifacts. An artifact is an object that was used by people in the past. These artifacts pictured below are from the Inca civilization of ancient Peru. The civilization was the largest empire in the Americas at the time. The Inca were known for creating new farming and building methods. They built the city of Machu Picchu without using sand or cement and without the help of the wheel. Long ago, Machu Picchu was abandoned. No one knows why this happened, but it might have been the result of disease. The artifact below is from the Mapungubwe cultural landscape. Mapungubwe was a large kingdom in southern Africa. Some of the people who lived there were gold and ivory traders. Others were successful farmers. However, the kingdom was abandoned in the 14th century. It's believed that the climate change caused people to leave the kingdom. The Mapungubwe cultural landscape is preserved so people can see the remains of this civilization. So the first picture we have on page 114, the caption underneath says, these tools and pottery are artifacts found in the ancient Inca city of Machu Picchu. They were rediscovered in 1911. And then on page 115, this rhinoceros artifact from the Mapungubwe cultural landscape is made of gold foil. It was found buried with the king. Now, interesting things that we find out about these is this is talking about two powerful civilizations. And both of them, for reasons that aren't really known for sure, were both completely abandoned and left. Now we're going to compare and contrast. To compare means to tell how two things are alike or how they're the same. And to contrast means to tell how they're different from each other. So we already read the text all the way through. We're going to look for words that signal comparison and contrast. So anything that says both, or some, or like, or how they're the same, will tell you that you are comparing. But if it says but or unlike, then you know you're contrasting. You're looking at something that's unique to each one. Think about the details in the text and the pictures. And based on the text, we're going to complete this Venn diagram at the bottom to talk about how each civilization is different and what they have in common. Now we know that we have the Inca civilization and artifact are on the left side. The Mapungubwe cultural landscape and artifact are going to be on the right side, and how they are the same will be in the middle. Now we know the Inca civilization was in Peru, and the tools and the things that they used, like the pottery in the picture, these were all practical everyday things that they were using. So the artifact that we have shows things that they use in their everyday life. Now for the Mapungubwe cultural landscape, we know that's located in southern Africa. And their artifact was a gold rhino that was used to honor someone of that's really high up in their communities. So, and we found out that that gold rhinoceros was buried with a king. So it was an artifact that was used to honor a ruler, as opposed to the ones that we found in the Incan civilization that were tools that were used in everyday life. Now, what's the same about them is that these were both very large empires. They both consisted of farmers and artists. They were interested in nature, but most interestingly, I think, is that both of these empires were completely abandoned. Now, for the following page on 117, we're going to read page 116 to 125 in our research companion. That's our textbook. And we're going to use our skills to look for text evidence that compares and contrasts the different cultures of Peru and South Africa. So we're going to list how they're different on either side. The oval on the left is for Peru. The oval on the right is for South Africa. And in the middle, we're going to put in things that show how they are alike. So there's going to be a lot of different options that you can select for these and use your textbook to select the ones that were most interesting to you. Two vibrant cultures. Comparing cultures in different communities can help us learn more about culture. The third largest country in South America is Peru. Many Peruvians are descended from the Inca. The Spanish have also influenced the country. Peru's main ethnic groups are the Amerindians, the name for the Native Americans on the continent of South America, the Mestizos, descendants of the Amerindians and Europeans. Asians, Peruvians descended from Africans and many other ethnic groups that live in Peru. The country's main religion is Catholicism. Many Amerindians combine traditional religious beliefs with Catholic ideas. Peru's official languages are Spanish and Quechua. Quechua is spoken by Amerindians in Peru and other South American countries. Most Peruvians live near the capital, Lima. South Africa is Africa's ninth largest country. It is on Africa's southern tip. South Africa's main ethnic groups are Black South Africans, multi-ethnic South Africans, and white South Africans and Asian South Africans. The country has 11 official languages because of its ethnic diversity. The majority are Christians. Others are Hindus, Muslims, Jews, and Buddhists. Most of the people live in cities such as Johannesburg and Pretoria. Let's go back and take a look at our picture here. People from South Africa and Peru make purchases at markets. So you can see the South African markets here and the Peruvian market in the smaller picture up above. The stories cultures tell about themselves. Lima. Myths, legends, and stories from the past tell much about a culture. In Peru's capital, Lima, and throughout Peru, people share stories about their history. The stories connect people to their Peruvian heritage and culture. Many of these stories tell about the origin of the world. Other stories tell about when the Inca ruled, about life after the Spanish came to Peru. People tell stories to explain events that occurred in the past and to relate those events to modern life. Lima and its surrounding areas have been important to Peru's culture for thousands of years. For example, Pachacamac was an important religious site near Lima long ago. Many pilgrims visited the site. It was named after their god, Pachacamac. His name means maker of the earth. According to legend, the god Pachacamac represented all living things. One story about him described how he created the first man and woman. Today, much of the ancient religious site has been restored so visitors can learn about the Inca culture. In Lima Centro, people share an identity and heritage that goes back thousands of years. Did you know? Many artifacts have been found in Peru. The Museo Larco has many ancient objects, including tools, highly detailed figures, and jewelry. Museo de la Nación is also in Peru and contains similar artifacts from ancient civilizations. Museums help people in Peru learn about their history. The most important of the Inca creator gods was Viracocha. According to legend, he created the sun, the moon, and the stars from Lake Titicaca. His first attempt at human life produced stone giants. They could not be controlled, so Viracocha got rid of them. Then he made people who were smaller and more manageable. This group turned out to be too proud and greedy, so Viracocha sent a great flood to destroy everything. However, he let three humans live. The humans brought about the human race. Many Amerindians continue to tell the story as part of their cultural heritage. Johannesburg. While citizens of Lima identify with heritage that goes back thousands of years, more recent history influences the identity of citizens of Johannesburg, South Africa. Johannesburg is the largest city in South Africa. Different groups of people live freely there. But at one time, the Black population in South Africa was denied rights and freedoms. White leaders ruled the country even though most South Africans were Black. The country followed a system of racial inequality and segregation called apartheid. Protests against apartheid lasted for many years. Police and government officials arrested protest leaders. One leader was Nelson Mandela. His arrest caused the rest of the world to notice what was happening in South Africa. In 1989, South Africa's government made a change. Leaders wrote a new constitution. Blacks won their freedom and rights back. Then in 1990, Mandela was released from prison. He continued to fight for reforms. South Africa's first democratic election took place in 1994. Nelson Mandela was elected president. With the end of apartheid, Archbishop Desmond Tutu of Cape Town, South Africa, began using the phrase Rainbow Nation to describe his country. Once a country that separated whites and blacks, it now united many cultures. Groups from different backgrounds had joined together to begin better lives in South Africa. Nelson Mandela talked about Tutu's Rainbow Nation idea early in his presidency. With his words, South Africa's nickname, Rainbow Nation, was set. South Africa's stories have been told for generations. South Africa's writers have also recorded apartheid events. These writings mean people will always remember what life was like in South Africa. Primary source in their words. Nelson Mandela. Each one of us is as intimately attached to the soil of this beautiful country as the famous jacaranda trees of Pretoria. A rainbow nation at peace with itself and the world. Biography, Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela organized nonviolent protests against South Africa's apartheid government. The government sentenced him to life in prison for treason. In prison, Mandela became a symbol of apartheid's injustice. He was thought of as a hero. After 27 years, Mandela was released from prison as apartheid ended. Nelson Mandela became South Africa's first Black president. During his presidency, he worked for unity and peace. Now, one of the things that you can mention in your graphic organizer, we can talk right here. We found some keywords that says that Johannesburg's heritage and influences were more recent than those found in Lima and in the Inca culture. Next, we're going to talk about art, music, dance, and food, and we're going to see some varieties in this section that you can also put. But you can put how these two different cultures are alike so far. It's because they rely very heavily and they lean very heavily on their traditions and customs, and they value their heritage. So their stories are passed down from generation to generation. A lot of the things that they value are very similar. Cultural arts and foods in Lima throughout Peru. The cultures of both Peru and South Africa blend ancient traditions with newer ones. So here you can see that they use the word both, and that's a good clue as to what you can put in that center section of your Venn diagram about how they are alike. Many Peruvians still make traditional arts and crafts. For example, some Amerindians make clothing from llama hair or sheep's wool. The Ayacucho made retablos, wooden altars for religious ceremonies in their homes. Today, craftspeople continue carving religious scenes for their altars. Spanish and Italian artists in Peru created paintings and sculptures for churches. Peru's music and dance also blend its history. Music from Peru's mountains, or Andean music, uses flutes and panpipes. Andean dance includes the huayno, a fast dance with colorful costumes. Criollo music comes from Peru's coast, including the marinera, a slow and romantic dance accompanied by guitar. People living on the coast enjoy seafood. In the Amazon jungle, people eat tropical fruits and fish. Traditional Andean dishes include potatoes and meat. Potatoes originally came from Peru. Now, looking at the pictures, we can see this Peruvian plays the panpipe. So you can see the instrument that he's playing, and he's blowing air into these pipes to make different sounds. And then in the bottom, potatoes came from Peru and are still very important to Peruvian culture. And we see a dish down there that's made with potatoes. Cultural arts and food in Johannesburg and throughout South Africa. A person traveling to South Africa might stumble across rock art. These prehistoric works show animals, tools, and activities of ancient times. Black folk art, such as beadwork, is tied to South African customs today. Today, it's used in clothing and may be a part of ceremonies. Popular South African music often combines traditional music, jazz, religious music, and other forms. Miriam Makeba was a Black South African singer who introduced Xhosa and Zulu songs to Western audiences. Gumboot dancing began with gold miners who worked and lived under terrible conditions. They began beating out rhythms with their boots in order to communicate with each other. Gumboot dancing spread outside the mines and is still performed today. People in South Africa enjoy traditional and modern foods. Bobotai, a meat pie with apricots, raisins, and curry flavoring, comes from the Dutch and English. Braai is a barbecue with beef, chicken, ostrich, or other game. Now, in the picture, we can see some of the Zulu bead art that they have. You can see these beautiful colors and designs that they make with different bead combinations. Traditions and holidays, traditional holidays and festivals. Holidays throughout Peru. Many people in Peru celebrate Catholic religious holidays. Dia de Santa Rosa de Lima honors Saint Rose of Lima, the first person born in the Americas to be made a saint. She's also a patron saint of South America. So this is something that you can list in the unique side of Peru. Another holiday is Dia de San Pedro y San Pablo, the feast of St. Peter and St. Paul. People attend special masses on these days. St. Peter is the patron saint of fishermen. Many decorate their boats in his honor. Peruvians celebrate their independence from Spain every year in a two-day celebration on July 28th and July 29th. Independence was not complete until 1824. However, July 28th, 1821 was the day it was first declared. The celebration is known as Fiestas Patrias. In Lima, there is a flag-raising ceremony and a 21-gun salute. People watch large military parades. An important festival during September in Lima is Mistura. It's South America's largest food festival. Chefs and restaurants from around the world serve some of Peru's best foods. Quinoa, a grain grown in the Andes Mountains, is served in a stew. People eat fish from the Amazon River and ceviche, a fish dish from the coast. About 500,000 people attend this event. South Africa. The Makhanda National Arts Festival is Africa's largest cultural event. It includes arts, crafts, and entertainment. It lasts for 11 days. More than 200,000 attend. People in South Africa also celebrate 7 new national holidays. These began in 1994 when apartheid ended. They are Human Rights Day, Freedom Day, Workers' Day, Youth Day, National Women's Day, Heritage Day, and the Day of Reconciliation. These days celebrate important values in South Africa. Some are updates of older apartheid holidays, For example, December 16th used to be a holiday called the Day of the Vow. In 1995, it became the Day of Reconciliation. Two important events happened on this day. In 1839, the Zulu army was defeated by the Voortrekkers in the Battle of Blood River. In 1961, the military branch of the African National Congress was created. The new name for the day was meant to build national unity. Now, if you take a look at the pictures on the right side, underneath, we can see a National Arts Festival in South Africa, and you can see the picture above. And underneath, a group of women celebrating Zulu culture during a Freedom Day parade. So now we've gone over a lot of different aspects of Peruvian and South African culture. We've looked at things that make them unique and ways that they're alike. You can go ahead and fill in your graphic organizer. If you need to list information underneath because those ovals aren't very big, you can go ahead and do that as long as your work is neat and organized. Now, in the Think About It and Write About It section, it says, based on the two cultures you learned about, write an opinion about how comparing two cultures helps you understand what culture means to a community, and use evidence from what you've read to support your answer. So make sure you're going back to your book and using examples from the reading to support the answer that you give. So make sure you clearly give your opinion about how comparing cultures helps people to understand more about each other's community, and use examples from the text. Now on the next page where it says connect to the essential questions, think about what the cultures of Peru and South Africa tell about culture. In what ways do their cultures show how cultures make communities unique? So make sure you're going through and giving lots of examples, explain how there are similarities between cultures, how there are things that are unique to each one, how each culture has its own language or languages, its own unique type of foods, its own unique clothing and stories, different religions that are followed in those particular cultures. So there's a lot of information you can draw on to fill this section. Once you're done with that, you'll be done with this lesson. If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye.